reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. There is a link between suffering and glory, a direct link between suffering and glory. The measure in which we suffer is the measure in which we are glorified. And why is that? Is it that the Lord Jesus is saying, look, if you're not willing to do this for me, then I'm not willing to give you any glory? Well, no, there's a far more practical reason than that. And that is that glory has a weight. And suffering is what develops our capacity to bear the weight. If you give something to someone, a blessing is a burden, isn't it? Every blessing that we receive is a burden. It's a stewardship, a responsibility. And so God is not going to give us more than we can bear. Brother Sidney Temple down in Augusta, Georgia, worked with the American government down in Panama. And he was saying that one day he was looking out the window and they were dredging the Panama Canal. And these big earth movers were rolling up and the jaws of this dredging machine would reach down and gather some sand, some silt, and dump it into these big earth movers, and they would shake, you know, and then they'd rumble away and the next one would pull in. And there was a little fellow in a pickup truck, and he was in the sand haulage business, and he wanted to get some sand too, and he pulled in line. And when he got up to his position, the crane operator waved him out of the way. Get out of the way, man! And he wouldn't get out of the way until he got some sand, so he gave it to him. And the little pickup truck just disappeared under a pile of sand. And, you know, sometimes if we got the prayers we prayed for, it would crush us. The Lord knows how much we can bear. Like the wee boy standing there as his father was loading up the firewood. And someone said, son, isn't that a big load for a little guy like you? And he said, well, my daddy knows how much I can carry. Now, the Lord knows how much we can carry. And he won't put an ounce more on us than we're able to bear. But obedience is what produces this strength, a willingness to submit to the will of God, whatever path that may take. That's what produces our spiritual muscle. The scripture speaks about growing in faith, developing our faith. If I say to someone, have faith, what does that mean? It's like saying to my son, have muscles. Well, he's not quite sure how to obey that command, have muscles. I don't say to him, have muscles. What I say is, take the garbage out. You know, help your mother with the groceries. And as he obeys me, one day he looks in the mirror and he sees these little bumps on his arms and he wonders where they came from. Well, they came from obedience. As we respond in obedience to the Word of God, we grow. We trust ourselves to some particular truth in the Scripture and we find out that it's true. We find it to be real and the light comes on and we say, this is true. God can be trusted in this area of my life and our faith in Him grows. And as we go through hard times and difficulties, we find out that God is enough, that God is able to sustain His people through any circumstances, and so we trust Him all the more. The more that we bear of suffering at this present time, the greater the capacity of glory that we can bear in the day to come.